The bibliography is not just part of your PhD thesis, it is a fundamental part of your PhD. And you should think carefully what you should or you should not include in the bibliography, because it can result in your thesis instantly rejected by the examiner. And in this short video, I'm going to explain you some of the precautions which you should take while making the bibliography. And if you are serious about your PhD, please watch this video till the end. And we are starting right after this short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir. And if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. First, let me clear that we are not talking about errors in your bibliography. I have made a video about how to download references for your bibliography and create a BibTeX file. If you are using LaTeX, you can watch that video. If you are using Mendeley or some other software, then you should avoid any errors. But even if there are some errors, this is not a serious issue, because your thesis will be sent back to you for minor corrections if there are only some errors. We are talking about some serious mistakes which you can easily do if you don't know. There are not many details about this, so therefore this video is very short but still very important for you. So let's talk about what are these five things. So the first is mix of references. So when your thesis is presented to your examiner, the first thing the examiner will look, of course it depends on the examiner, but an experienced examiner will start looking at your thesis from the end. That person most probably will look first on your bibliography. And what he or she is looking for is a mixed list of references. What an examiner would expect is that most of your references are relevant to your thesis title, most are journal articles, some are conferences, and few are other like technical reports or any PhD thesis. And the title of the references or the title of the research papers which you have listed there, they are closely related to your field of research. So this is just an overlook of your bibliography. And this leads us to the second point, which is irrelevant keywords. Sometimes you want to put a reference to something which is related to your work, but which is in a paper which is not related to your research. So if the title of the paper is totally different to your field of research, so try to think again whether you really want to put that reference in, or you can get the same reference from an earlier paper which is somewhat related to your research field. Because the keywords in the titles of the research papers in your bibliography are very important. I have mentioned this earlier that when you start your PhD, you should make a very comprehensive list of all the related keywords in your field of research. These keywords will help you in finding the relevant papers and also while you sit back and start writing your PhD thesis. Because I would like to see a bibliography full of related keywords in the title of the papers, in the title of the technical reports and everywhere. Now the third point is textbook references. When you start your PhD, sometimes you don't know a basics and you try to understand something very basic, some basic law of science or some basic principle in your field of research, and you find this in one of the textbooks. And if you don't know this, you might be tempted to put the reference of that textbook in your PhD thesis. Remember, all textbook references in the PhD thesis can lead to a disaster, because all that knowledge is an established knowledge. You should not be mentioning that in your thesis. But if you have learned some specialized technique, I remember that during my PhD, I learned principal component analysis, which was a technique for data analysis. And I put the reference to that technique, but that book is a specialized book. That is not a textbook. So if you are putting a reference to a very specific book related to your field, that is perfectly fine. But if you don't know the Pythagoras theorem, and then you put a reference to your HSC book or even a university level book, that is a total crap. The next point is failing to put a major work in your bibliography. You must understand who are the top researchers in your field of research. And this is the first thing you should understand when you start doing PhD. I have made a separate video and I will put a link at this place in this video which you can watch to learn how you can find the top researcher in your field. In the beginning of your PhD, you normally start reading some conference papers because general paper at that time might be too difficult for you, and you are so attached to any of those conference papers that you select that for your bibliography and you start putting in the references. But you don't know that that particular researcher has presented his whole work later on in a journal paper, which is his major work, and you should be aware of that work. So once you find the top researcher, then you have to keep yourself abreast with their latest work. For example, my PhD was in mobile robotics, and a scientist named Sebastian Thrun was a leading researcher in that field at that time. So if my thesis does not contain any of his reference, then it will be an instant reject because I am missing a very renowned scientist. So make sure you don't do that. And the last point is about toxic references. Some of the references are so toxic, I would say, that they can lead to an instant rejection of your PhD thesis. What are those toxic references? Well, some people have presented some research work or some keywords they have thrown up in the industry, which have been proved to be wrong, incorrect, and flawed. And now, if you get to know any of those papers and then you try to build your argument, try to build your story on top of that paper and saying that this is wrong because this and I have done this and that, then basically you are trying to prove something wrong which has already been proven to be wrong, incorrect. And if an examiner sees any of this kind of thing in your thesis or in your references, then it will be an instant rejection and you will fail your PhD. Your 5 years' efforts will be lost. Your thesis will not be sent back to you for correction. You will fail absolutely. So therefore, avoid this critical mistake. You should be aware of these type of researchers. And now regarding what you should put in the bibliography, there is no set rules that how many journal papers or how many conference papers you should put there. But because I know that students want to get some numbers, so therefore I'm throwing these numbers that you should be putting 60 to 70% journal papers in your bibliography, 10 to 20% conference papers, and 5 to 10% other references such as technical reports or some PhD thesis. So this is just my own personal opinion. This is not written anywhere, or there is no such rule. So I hope that this short video will help you avoid these little mistakes in your bibliography. I have a lot of videos about PhD students on my channel. And if you are a PhD student, you must watch all of those videos. Those will help you. And if you have any questions, please put in the comments and I will definitely answer your questions. Thanks for watching. See you next time.